there some way we can gather?
The Philippine Consulate in Toronto recently hosted a seminar in support of the 18-day campaign to end violence against women. In her speech, Consul General Angelica Scolona shared the heartbreaking story of a former co-worker who became a victim of violence.
She was a hardworking, kind, and gentle person. Last year, I received the news that she was killed by her estranged husband. I was shaken to the core by the news. I never thought it would happen to her or to anyone I know.
This case shared by Scalona is among the many incidents of violence experienced by women that they want to address through the consulate. Scalona says they are looking at VAWSI from the perspective of migrant workers and international students in Canada and what the community can do to prevent these incidents. Giselle Sabiel, representing the Catholic Children's Aid Society, highlighted that immigrants are susceptible to various forms of abuse and violence, whether inflicted by intimate or non-partners.
When they come here, it's hard to navigate the system, right? And then immigration comes with a lot of challenges. Like, say, for example, for students, the cost of housing, the cost of living, which creates more challenges and stress for the family, which may place them more vulnerable to abuse and violence.
This sentiment was echoed by Latoya Dwyer of Assaulted Women's Helpline, who reveals that a significant portion of their callers are new immigrants and refugee claimants seeking assistance.
23% of our callers that call us are new immigrants to the country, and 5% are refugee claimants when they call us. But if you look at the calls that are being reported to police in your cities, then you will see how many calls have been made trying to get help that have been, you know, experiencing intimate partner violence.
Strides Toronto's psychotherapist Liberty Katbagan encourages everyone to speak up if they experience any form of violence.
Kunyari yung mga hindi kayo alam, natatakot kayong mag-report sa police, mag-report sa CAS, yung mga resources na yan, pwede nating gamitin para makakuha kayo ng free services kung tumawag sa Strides Toronto.
During the seminar, Emeline Quinto raised the lack of actual data on victims that consulate officials admit still needs to be addressed.
We need to know the age, even the gender, because it's not only women who are also suffering that. I think it's good to know for research, policy research. I think the consulate office should also have data on that, statistics on that.
I'm a great believer in data, yes. Because data will back you up when you have recommendations. So if there's some way we can gather and we can talk about this for the Filipino community specific data, then we can talk about that.
Escalona also emphasized the importance of collaboration between the consulate and community organizations to address this issue effectively. If you or someone you know is being abused, call 911 or 211 immediately. You can also contact the Assaulted Women's Helpline numbers. Jocelyn Reyes Sambilay, ABS-CBN News, Toronto.